In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Last Thursday, we celebrated the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we wonder really whether the Lord needs to be ascended. Does he? Of course not, because the Son never departed from the Father. But the whole issue of salvation and the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ is to take us all back to heaven, back to the Holy of Holies. It started when our Lord being incarnate, when he took flesh and being born. Our Lord, when he created Adam and Eve, he created them to be with him. But as a matter of fact, Adam and Eve sinned, died, and couldn't do anything till our Lord Jesus Christ has come and said, we have to change things. I would not leave the man to be with me. No, because man sinned and died and couldn't do anything. So the Lord came to say, I will take man inside me. I will unite with man and the humanity all, so that even if they sin, they wouldn't die. I will carry on their sins and forgive them and bring them back to be pure and spotless. So the Lord took us all inside him in the incarnation and made it more and more when he actually completed this unity in the Last Supper. In the Last Supper, he said that I am leaving. And they kept saying, where are you leaving to? He said, I will tell you. He took them to the Last Supper, took the bread, made it to be his body, and took the wine, made it to be his blood, and broke himself and gave himself to us, to be in him and he inside us. Then our Lord Jesus Christ took us all in him and went on the cross. And on the cross, he forgave us all. And he carried all our sins on him. He took what is ours and gave us what is his. Then the Lord wanted to save us from death. So he himself went with us into that tomb. That death, he took the death on himself and then been risen to defeat that death. He conquered death. He abolished death and defeated its power and made no death anymore. Whoever believes in me would never die. Even when we pray on the deceased, we say, he didn't die, he just departed. He just traveled to different place. So he conquered that death for all of us. And then he took us inside him and went with the disciples at the day of ascension. He blessed them and started to go up, 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 up. And the disciples keep looking at him till he disappeared. When he disappeared, they kept looking up. And the angel of the Lord came and said, why are you looking up? That one who has come up will come back. And the disciples couldn't understand why he would come back. He would come back to take us all up in him, to be in the bosom of the Father, in between his faithful hands, and as well sitting on his right side in his power. And that is the most glorious thing the Lord has done to us all. In the Old Testament, it was not possible for man to go into the Holy of Holies. It was only the high priest who can go in, even not any other priest. And he goes once a year. He took the blood of sacrifices and go in. But before he goes in, they must make sure that he is absolutely pure. They keep bathing him, showering him every few hours to make sure he is spotless. He take off all his clothes and put on linen clothes, not made, and go in terribly, terribly in fear, because if he has got any wrong thing, he will die. Then he gives incense before he goes in, till the whole holy place will be full of incense. Then he goes to put the blood of the sacrifice on the Ark of Covenant before the Lord, which was a symbol of his sacrifice. So he came as a high priest, took us all inside him and went to the Holy of Holies to be all pure and stay there forever. The actions of our Lord never end. His unity with us is continuous forever. and for everyone in this whole world, to whoever believes and get baptized, will unite with the Lord. That is why we all being united with the Lord, we all being in the Last Supper, took him inside us and became inside him. And we all been risen and we all been ascended. How great is that? How great? How great to see yourself really in the Holy of Holies, in the bosom of the Father, on his right hand side. That is why St. Paul said, when I am weak, I am strong in him. If you always keep remembering you are in him and he is inside you, you will never be weakened. You will never be depressed. Just trust what he said. Just live what you are. Then our Lord Jesus Christ left for his disciples few things. He said, my peace I leave to you. And said to the disciples, if I go, I will send you the Holy Spirit. And you will be filled with power. When the Holy Spirit descends upon you, you will have power. And when you have this power, you will be my witness. You will be going to all nations and bringing them the good news, the news of salvation, and to baptize them and to bring them to be one in me too. It is a glorious thing that the Lord has done, fulfilling his salvation with that great glory to everyone. Can anyone then now say, I can't do anything? Can you? Can you say, I am hopeless? Can you say, I am weak? No, no, no. In him, we are united with him. We are risen, we are ascended, and keep ascending all the time. So what we need from all of us to keep looking up, 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 and to keep saying, I am ascending, I am in him, and I am in the Father, living in the Holy of Holies. May our Lord give us all to live this holy life and always see ourselves in him up in heaven, even though we are still on earth. Glory to God forever.